genetic immunoallergy, that is gastroesophageal reflux disease. It is a disease, a disorder, you can say, which affects the renal esophageal sphincter. The renal has muscles between esophagus and stomach. Reflux means flow back. Flow back, the content of the stomach, when it returns back to the esophagus because of the laxity, that causes inflammation in the lower and mid and lower part of the esophagus. That is what is GERD. So basically, the symptoms are very common. Patient mostly complains with indigestion, then the bitter taste in the mouth, then they complain with stomach pain beneath the sternum. These are the very vague symptoms from which they come. And the factors which contributes to this GERD is nothing but the food and beverages we eat, including the chocolate, peppermint, then your fried foods, spicy and alcoholic beverages. These are the foods which causes more reflux. Okay, now see the treatment part is we see. Okay, for diagnosis we don't have to do much understanding. We have to do mostly the clinical diagnosis. When we do endoscopy, we find there is inflammatory changes of the lower esophagus and there is a laxity of the ileus. We have three things by which we diagnose mostly the GERD. And also we exclude any pathology like ulceration or something like that in endoscopy. We exclude that without keeping a diagnosis of GERD. Now the management is very simple. The management is very simple, like it is the basically the lifestyle management. Like you have to change your lifestyle and your food habits. Lifestyle management means you have to maintain certain timing. You have to take food regularly in a regular interval. You have to do regular exercises to make your body fit for all your things in the whole day. You have to prepare yourself for the whole day. And next it comes.